This is one of the new areas, and we started, we are working last 2 years only, and many of the things we do not understand, and theory also, you know, very new, and so I am not going to present any theoretical equation or idea. I only present experiment, and wherever it is required, some expression for explaining our result. But I think the result itself important, and you can differentiate with existing systems which so far we deal with. And by the way, the most of the systems, almost all the systems are very old, and they studied during 60s. And many physical properties which I am going to present, or people, many of them are old, but physics is new. This is the thing. Not many of the measurements were done during 60s and 70s, but people did not know what is the physics, rich physics behind this. Okay, with this, so my the title of my talk is Titanic Magnetoresistance and Signature of Non-Degenerate Dirac Nodes in Zirconium Silicon Sulfur. Let us see how far I can go. Okay, an interesting thing is that this field of research involves different branches in science. For example, condensed matter physics, material science. Why material science? Because these are the materials earlier known as thermoelectric materials. Because of high conductivity and large value of thermoelectric power, they are known as thermoelectric materials. And this is very, that's why it is very old. People for a long time working in this field for practical and technological application. But several experimental tools that is new, that were not applied before. And many other branches, particle physics, most of the theoretical idea came from particle physics. In fact, few days before, one of my colleague in particle physics, he says that, well, many of the particle physicists now, they are changing towards the condensed matter physics. So this is one, maybe you can see one of the speakers sitting here, she is also from other branches of physics, but recently working in this field. Okay. Just maybe you have noticed in last few years, several things which were mostly predicted or came from the theory of particle physics. One of them is skarmion. And this was long ago in 60s from, you know, that Tony Skarmi, he predicted theoretically possible what is the skarmion in particle physics. But only in 8 years before, seven, 8 years before, this was experimentally realized by condensed matter experimentalists in manganese silicon. And later on, several other materials also shows skarmionic phase, magnetic, different kind of skarmion. For example, here I have shown one is the first one. You can see that spins are outward, and it is known as hedgehog, whereas this one is spiral. So this is one thing experimentally realized, but predicted from the particle physics. Similarly, another field of research, you may know that Majorana fermion, that also several experiments are going on. So I do not know in future whether some other things like magnetic monopole will be experimentally realized or not. Okay, now I just particularly for students, I just go through some very simple things to differentiate these materials with conventional materials. So my talk mostly for students. So this is very elementary level. So you all know that normally we categorize the material based on electronic properties. Either it is insulator, in that case valence band and conduction band is separated by a gap. And of course, depending on the value of gap, we can say it is insulator or semiconductor. So we do not have any carrier to conduct charge at zero temperature. Only when we increase the temperature, charge carrier thermally activated and they participate. And that gives you exponential behavior due to the exponential behavior of the activation. And on the other hand, in metal, you know the two bands, they overlap. And this is the schematic presentation in energy versus K. Now, most of the things, I think some of the things already are previous speakers introduced, but I just mentioned in a very, okay. You also know that in normal metals or in condensed matter physics, effectively we deal with the system where energy and momentum, they are related in quadratic way, and mass get renormalized mostly. And this mass, many of you know that this mass can be very large, particularly for have any idea about heavy fermion, then this mass can go very close to proton. It can more than people now reported 1,000 times the rest mass of electron. So where mass, of course, simple things will not be, is not valid, but mass get renormalized. But energy and momentum, basically they show quadratic relation. This can be understood from this symbol relation. Now, but in there are some metals where this relation is no longer as quadratic, but this you have idea from Dirac's relativistic equation, in this equation, and if your mass is, if we put the mass 0, then we can see energy and momentum, they are linearly dependent. So this equation, and similar, now this equation, if you can, you can see there is a very similarity, that means analogy between this expression and in condensed matter in Dirac system that I come to soon, where Fermi velocity plays an important role. Here velocity of light is replaced by the Fermi velocity. And this is the corresponding equation I am not going to discuss, where from you get this expression. So Fermi velocity plays the role of speed of light in real system. Okay. Now how it happens, actually those who attended earlier talks, maybe you have seen same picture was presented. So when band crossing, it is also known as band inversion, you can see when band crosses at two points, they intersect, and in that case, in some materials, in real material I will come soon, then their band, due to the bulk, that shows a gap. This is the bulk band gap, bulk band, conduction band, and this is valence band. And at this point, surface states has linear behavior, and they cross each other. And the crossing point is known as the Dirac point. So with this, so I have presented here in expanded view is shown here. So you can see the valence band and conduction band, they are separated by gap, whereas the surface state has no gap. Okay. How, what is real material? One is very known that graphene, which is two dimensional. So in graphene, you do not have any bulk, so you have a only surface state that is linear. But in graphene, the physics is different. I'm not going to discuss, unlike Dirac, because magnetic field plays a role. And you can see that it is also linear dispersion is shown.
that energy and momentum experimentally it has been shown. Okay, now I go straight to my work. What we do, we study magnetic and transport properties. From there we can show that whether these systems possess the trivial or non-trivial band structure. That means whether they are linear band related to the physics linear band or quadratic band. This is simple experiment, but we can derive the idea. I briefly discuss how the sample is, you know that sample is very important to, because if your sample is not good, then you may not be able to observe the quantum oscillation. So sample preparation is one important thing, and we develop. We usually grow samples in two different ways. One is flux. It can be self flux. It can be other added flux. And other is chemical vapor transport. In chemical vapor transport, we prepare the polycrystalline sample. Flux method you know, but this is new. New means mostly chemical vapor transport is used. So in chemical vapor transport, we keep the sample in one end of the quartz tube sealed, of course high vacuum sealed, and other end, so sample and the other end has a temperature gradient. And if we keep it for long time, then you can have, just like many things, you know, that sublimate at colder end. This is the basic like that. So it's sublimation like thing, but it is very slow process so that you can have a good sample. And sometimes, for example, that centrifuge, high temperature centrifuge we build in our lab, we did not know that how can it be separated from flux. Okay. Well, this is another very simple thing. You can see, let us have two resistance, R1 and R2. One is metal and other is insulator. And have a parallel circuit and you measure equivalent resistance at different temperatures. Then what do you expect? You expect the red curve. You expect the red curve. And what is the black curve? That I come to in next slide. This is a real picture where in nature you can have two such systems. Why? Look, this is simple. This is metal. At low temperature, this will dominate. But at high temperature, you know that due to activated type of conductivity increases with temperature in semiconductor, whereas in metal just opposite. So if you have a two such things, there will be a crossover where metal will dominate at low temperature, whereas semiconductor will dominate at high temperature. So this simple idea, if you do and just calculate, then you will find this curve. Now let us see whether it happens. And this is a crossover. This is not a phase transition. Let us see a real picture. That curve I have shown nothing but this one. And this is the system known as topological insulator. In this case, in this system, you look that current is flows through the surface, not through the bulk. But at high temperature, when bulk conductivity is higher than surface, as you can see in earlier slide I have shown, it is possible, then at high temperature, bulk will dominate, but at low temperature, surface will dominate. And this is the curve experiment and that fitting with parallel circuits. And what is, and you can see from heat capacity, there is no, at this point, there is no anomaly, so it is not a phase transition. So I do not discuss details, but only I briefly tell you what is the main and important findings in our result. There are many reported many people reported this behavior in BSTS resistivity, but so far, all the reported results, in that case, resistivity just saturates. they did not find the resistivity to decrease at low temperature. So this is the first experimental evidence where bulk and surface you can clearly separate. And the main physics is that resistivity at low temperature shows T square dependence. I think this is the first experimental evidence where two-dimensional electron gas shows T square dependence of resistivity without any magnetic or any perturbation. There is one report in PRL, I think 20 years before, in two-dimensional electron gas, but where they applied magnetic field, perpendicular magnetic field, to create a superlattice. Theoretically, it was predicted long ago that resistivity should be T square dependent, similar to similar to 3D lambda Fermi liquid, but in 2D there were no experimental evidence. So this is the first experimental evidence on that. Okay. Now I come to, well, this is another interesting thing. This is the field where first theory predicted and experiment confirmed. This is one example. This was theoretically predicted to be a topological insulator. And you can see, I have shown earlier, and you can see this is experimental curve where you can see clearly surface state shows crossing at Dirac point and bulk has a gap. And this was reported in 2008. In bismuth, when it is doped with 10% antimony, it shows the topological insulating state. Okay, so, but bulk is not insulator for different reason. That's, there is another, I'm not going to discuss, but it is confirmed. I'm not going to discuss these things because I cannot finish. Because this will be also confirmed from magnetic measurement, I want to say. And in short, all diamagnetic samples should show linear linear dependence with magnetization. This you know that in diamagnetic, magnetization is proportional to H. So one should expect linear MH curve. But in topological insulator, because of these, because of the spins at the Dirac point contribute, they are frustrated, they should act in a paramagnetic, like a paramagnetic impurity. So they show a peak at magnetization. And there is also theoretical, definite theoretical. Yeah, yeah, these are all our work. Yeah. Okay. So this is theoretical equation, but I am not going. So let us think about this system. This is one of the two system. Again, theoretically predicted to be 3D Dirac semi-metal. This is one, and another is sodium bismuth, Na3Bi, to be predicted topological insulator, sorry, 3D Dirac semi-metal. Again, 3D Dirac semi-metal is very similar. It is an analog of graphene. Graphene is a 2D Dirac semi-metal, whereas these are 3D. That means you have Kx, Ky, and Kz. But in graphene, you have Kx and Ky. This is different. But physics is different. In a, some similarity, but not everything similar. Hmm. So this is also our work, where you can see in magnetization as well as resistivity, there is a clear oscillation. Hmm. And we can separate. And then from there, we can construct a different, we can calculate different parameters related to Fermi surface. Hmm. And we did, and also we extensively explain and give explanation for how the nature of transport changes with magnetic field in these two papers. So I, but this, okay, I'm not going to discuss details about this, then I cannot finish. Let us go to next, that is really amazing. You see this curve. Hmm. You can see how that residual resistivity is as low as 20 nanohm centimeter. So this is very like good metal, of the order of nanometer, and residual resistivity ratio is few thousands. For example, here it is given, it it reaches, that means the resistivity value at 300 Kelvin divided by resistivity value at 2 Kelvin, that reaches as high as 4000. This is a remarkable. Even in good metal, it is difficult to achieve. But this, and you can see, they prepare a lot of sample, and how it varies. It varies from, it is other 5 to 5,000. Actually, it depends on the morphology. This is another unique thing, that sample morphology. That means if it is a whisker-like thing, then resistivity ratio is huge. And this, and on the other hand, if you look the carrier density, now you all know that conductivity is determined by two factors, either carrier or mobility. You see, carrier remains almost same. There is no significant change, even not a factor of 2. Hardly factor of 2. Whereas here you have a change of 3 order of magnitude. So that means this simply tells you that mobility plays important role in conductivity. And that's why these systems are important for thermoelectric, because in thermoelectric you can enhance only with increasing mobility, but not due to charge carrier. If you increase the carrier, then conductivity will also, thermal power will also decrease. So Hughes, this opens a field that using high mobility, it can be used for thermoelectric power. Yeah, and you can see that few order of carrier density difference between this and condenser. Okay, let us. So this is another thing, very recent. It was theoretically predicted, and we started. This is the band structure. If you look, there are 6 Dirac points, Dirac nodes, and 4 are very close to the Fermi energy. And this reported, I think, theoretically reported 2015. And this group started measurement RPS, and we immediately started transport simultaneously. So in their paper, they at the note added also, they included that similar work is also done in other group. This is a typical shape for single crystals, and characterization you can see high quality from that high resolution tape. TEM, you can see very clear periodic areas of layers. Okay, so with this, I straight away go to my result here. Very similar to cadmium arsenide, you can see the resistivity of the ground crystal is very low. It is comparable. It is also of the about 50 nano ohm centimeter at 2 Kelvin. And this is also, and resistivity ratio is about 300. So this is one of the best sample we have prepared, and compared to also other different groups. And you can see resistivity, when I apply a small magnetic field, it changes from metal to semiconducting like behavior, and one can see that resistivity ratio along different crystallographic direction is very sensitive to direction of crystallography crystal. If I may, this is tetragonal, of course, this is tetragonal and highly anisotropic. This is another unique. Cadmium arsenide is 3D isotropic, but this is highly anisotropic. That can be seen from the magnetoresistance also, that anisotropy ratio in magnetoresistance is about 20. And resistivity, people could not measure along different directions. Different means within plane and out of plane could not measure. So from these magnetoresistance measurements, we have seen clear oscillation. You can see one is very high frequency and one very low. From there, we isolated from Fourier transform. We can calculate two different frequencies. One is, I think, about 238 Tesla, and other one is, I think, 20 Tesla, roughly. This is 20 Tesla, and other high frequency. Yes, high frequency is about 240, and this is about acting. So from there, one can calculate that Fermi surface cross section perpendicular to magnetic field, and also different other parameter, for example, effective mass of charge carrier. That is very important. That can be calculated from analyzing these results. But you can see that RT, if I plot RT, that contains beta. From there, we can calculate effective mass. Effective mass means cycloton mass. And this is, this work was published in PNAS in 17. Okay. And you can see from the plot, Landau plot, this is most important part. From the Landau plot, we have two Fermi pockets. From the Landau plot, one have an intercept. And this intercept, from the value of intercept, one can say whether it is a normal metal or it is a, that is, or people say, trivial band structure or non-trivial. If I have a copper, suppose hypothetically I do the same experiment for copper, then intercept here, you can see the intercept value I have shown here is about 0.15. If I do the same thing for copper, then I expect the value is half. This is given by Lipsitz-Onsegar quantization relation. The parameters here, that beta, I have shown here, 2 pi beta, that means beta should be half. If it is a non-trivial, that means Dirac-like system or topological insulator. On the other hand, that trivial band structure, that means conventional band, in that case, beta should be 1. So with that, one can differentiate whether it is trivial and non-trivial. And two more minutes? Okay. And here I have plotted the magnetization data. And here you can clearly see that very distinct, and there is a separation of peak due to the Zeeman splitting. That means up and down spin, it splits even at a low field of 9 Tesla. What is then important, if I have a higher field, then one can go to the lowest Landau level. You can see that this we have been achieved. We can go up to 2, n equal to 2 or so. So if I can have higher field, then we can achieve, we can go to the lowest Landau level, and then you can see that different quantum phenomena in this system. Okay. This is our Hall measurements. From there, we have calculated carrier density with different for different pockets, and our results. In short, this is the theoretical prediction: 4 bands very close to Fermi energy, and you can see 2 bands, 1 and 2, they are exactly at the Fermi energy. So you do not expect any contribution from this. So you expect from 2. One is hole, and one is hole, and another is electron. And we in fact observe the same thing. One is hole pocket, and another is electron pocket. And you can see electron density is much lower than hole. And this work, I can't finish. So let us. This is another aspect, that chiral anomaly. This idea came from high energy physics. That means this says that if you have a Dirac system and if you apply magnetic field parallel to electric field, then you have a extra current, and that can be fitted with experimental theoretical data. This we also observe in several systems. And this is not a Lorentz force. You normally, in no other material, you expect the magnetic field parallel to electric field in a non-magnetic material to have a negative magnetoresistance. Okay, this we observed in this system and also other systems. And this work, this is about our work. This work has been considered as one of the as top 1% according to Thomson Reuters citation, based on citation. So far, it received 550 citations.
Within 1 month.
No, not within 1 month. This was published in, February, end of February. Okay, same we observe in other system, I think. Just this is very important. Now, we did not observe zero mass. But, so this is one thing people argue why you are saying then Dirac. But it has been shown in graphene, if you change the carrier density in some point when the carrier is really very low, one can see that mass tending towards the zero. And similarly, Fermi velocity also diverges. Like, so this is somehow, this is experimental, not theoretical. So this is consistent. That means when you, that means from collective to particle-like thing, when you approach, maybe you observe the zero mass. That means collective to particle. So this is our group, our students, those who contributed in this work. But besides this, we have a collaboration for other works with other different groups. One of them is Ochinto. We are doing Ramon at high pressure with him. Thank you.